Hey Blade Ops, today we're doing a knife discussion video and we'll be talking about pocket real estate. So if you have a knife and you're going to carry it, an EDC or some sort of blade like that, a big question is pocket real estate. So I will grab the SOG Twitch 2 to explain a little bit what we're talking about when we say pocket real estate. We close up the blade, we clip it in our pocket using the pocket clip. We have the width this way, the thickness of how much the pocket it takes up when you clip it in, length, just overall volume of what the knife is occupying in our pocket. I mean, today's day and age, we got a ton of stuff in our pockets, you know, phones, wallets, keys, knives, all kinds of stuff, flashlights. You might carry a ton of gear, so it may or may not be important of how much pocket real estate your knife takes up. Also, one thing to consider, for example, like the Twitch 2, is how much pocket real estate does it take up according to how long the blade is or how multifunctional it is or how many tasks this particular knife can do for how much real estate it takes up. So we'll go ahead and start the discussion. We never claim to be the experts on everything or know every answer. That's why we opened it up to you guys, the fans. Comment down below and feel free to let us know what you think. We'll go through a few of the knives and talk about, we kind of split the knives into two. We have the Cold Steel Recon 1 and the Zero Tolerance 301. Those are kind of the opposite of what we talk about when we talk about slim knives that take up minimal pocket real estate but accomplish pretty big tasks. So we'll start at the top. We have the Benchmade Pardue Auto, an excellent slim, small pocket real estate knife that, you know, it's an automatic. It's got an over 3-inch blade. It's gonna do a ton of tasks for what you're getting. It has the 154cm steel blade, and best part, minimal pocket real estate. So there's one, and probably one of the most popular out the fronts, the Microtech Ultratech. And for me, one of the best parts about it is it's very slim. It doesn't take up a ton of pocket real estate. You're still getting a pretty big blade, a high quality out the front, and no one can do what Microtech is doing with an out the front this slim, with an action this smooth, and that long of a blade. So that's definitely one to talk about when you're talking about out the fronts. You have the Swindle here, the Protech Newport, SOG Twitch 2, all very popular knives, and I think they're popular because they're easy to carry. They don't take up a ton of room. They have a nice size blade for how long the handle is. Also ones to mention that I don't have here, Kershaw Cryo, very popular, nice and slim, Delica, Dragonfly, Endura. Those are all great folders. They don't take up a ton of room and still accomplish the tasks that they need to. And like I said, the opposite of that, the Zero Tolerance 301 spring assisted blade. This is a heavy duty, you know, military, law enforcement, beater blade, everyday carry. It's got the frame lock design. It's on the heavier side. This is gonna hold up to a ton of abuse. And it's a great product. But when you're talking about pocket real estate, this takes up a ton of real estate. I'll hold my my phone next to it just so you can get an idea. You know, that's thicker than my phone, and I'd say width-wise, it's about a third of an inch less, but you know, that takes up a ton of real estate. So that's something you want to consider when buying an everyday carry knife. Do the functionality and the features outweigh how much room it's taking? This is a great blade. Don't want to downplay the 301 at all. Great blade. And of course, the Recon 1 is one of the most popular folders out there. Super solid, heavy use, everyday carry blade. It has that triad lock, locks up super solid. G10 handle scales, excellent blade by Cold Steel. But definitely one thing to consider when you clip it in your pocket like so, it's gonna take up a ton of real estate. And maybe that outweighs the features that you're getting for it. Let's just compare it to, say, the Benchmade Pardue we had earlier. That gives you a good idea of how much room it's taking up. So, and maybe that's not important to you. Maybe that has nothing to do with why you buy a knife. We're just opening up the discussion as to pocket real estate and how much room your knives are taking up. So, and really, we're not saying one way is better than the other, one knife is better than the other. It's just something to consider when you're buying a knife How much room is it going to take up in your pocket? It's not something that you can really read about in the specs and get a grasp on it. That's one reason we like to do these videos. So comment down below. Let us know what you think about pocket real estate, everyday carry knives, and what maybe the optimum size is or how much room it takes up in your pocket and what your thoughts are on it. Comment down below and check it out. Blade Ops.